If you're new to investing, you may think you need a lot of money to invest, or that the stock market is too volatile to make money. Truth is that getting started is much easier than you may think. Understanding a few basic concepts can give you the confidence you need to begin. In this video, we are going to discuss some concepts of investing for beginners so that you can begin your journey to build wealth. By the way, welcome to Money Matters. Our goal is to give you the best tools, advice, and up-to-date tips and strategies so that you can live your best life. If you enjoy content like this, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for up-to-date information. What is investing? Essentially, investing is a long-term strategy to help you grow your wealth and pursue longer-term goals, like paying for a down payment on a new house and funding retirement. You may be wondering how investing and saving are different, since they both involve putting money away for the future. A savings account gives you easier access to your money, but it's a lower risk and lower reward option. With investing, you accept more risk in exchange for potentially greater returns over time. Why invest? Investing's key ingredient is compounding, which occurs when you reinvest the investment's earnings to potentially generate more earnings. Consider this example. Let's say you invest $10,000 when you're 25. With a consistent 5% return on that investment over a period of 40 years, compounded annually, you'll potentially have $70,400 at age 65. The earlier you start investing, the longer your investments have to generate more earnings. Things to consider before investing include your overall investment strategy, meaning what are your goals? What do you want to accomplish? Your age and time frame are other important factors, as well as your risk tolerance level. Do you want to be more aggressive or more conservative? Keep in mind that your investment strategy should evolve throughout your life. Consider taking on more risk when you're younger, since you have more time to recover from potential losses. As you get older, however, consider lowering your risk in preparation for retirement. Types of investments. There are a lot of choices when it comes to investing your money. The most common investment vehicles are stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and exchange-traded funds, ETFs. Stocks are shares of a company, also known as equity. Essentially, you own a small portion of a company when you buy stock. You make money on stocks when they appreciate in value or through dividends paid by the company to shareholders. Bonds are small loans given to a corporate or government entity. If you purchase bonds, you're expecting to receive repayment of your investment plus a set rate of interest for a specific period of time. In general, the longer the period of time, or maturity, the higher the interest rate on the bond. Mutual funds are a type of investment fund that's professionally managed. You and other investors contribute to the fund, and the fund manager invests in a large group of assets, generally stocks and bonds. ETFs are similar to mutual funds, but instead of investing directly into a fund, you buy shares on a public exchange, similar to buying stock. How to start investing? You have choices when it comes to investment accounts. What's right for you depends on what you're looking for. Here are a few to consider. You can start investing your spare change, literally, through the convenience of mobile apps such as Acorns and Stash. These investment accounts are designed for investing beginners and offer access to investment education along the way. Other apps such as M1 Finance and Robinhood are also great platforms to begin your investing journey. If you have more money to invest and are ready for a higher level of service, consider using a robo-advisor. You provide your goals, timeline, and risk tolerance, and the robo-advisor selects and monitors your investments for you. Another easy way to invest is through an employer-sponsored retirement account, if you have access to one. Think 401k and 403b accounts. Contributions are directly withdrawn from your paycheck, typically with pre-tax dollars, and many employers match contributions, up to a certain amount. Investing can seem intimidating at first, but understanding these basic concepts can help you begin your journey on the right foot. The most important thing is to just get started. That's all for today's video. Comment below with your thoughts and let us know if we missed anything. If you are new here, welcome. Subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos like this. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, money matters.